The block break is shown in figure is to balance a torque of 500 Newton meter on a drum shaft at 1000 RPM. Assuming the coefficient of friction between the brake shoe and drum to be 0.25 and 2 theta is less than 60 degree. So this is the condition given. Determine first tangential force on the shoe, second normal force on the shoe, third force F applied to the brake for clockwise and counterclockwise rotation, fourth the dimension C required to make the brake self-locking, assuming the other dimensions remain the same. And lastly, calculate heat generated. So in the given question, there are two cases which they have given. So where in one case, brake drum is rotating in clockwise direction, which is shown by orange color. And in another case, brake drum is rotating counterclockwise direction, which is shown by blue color. You can see in the figure, the brake drum is resting on a shoe, and this brake drum is exerting a normal reaction force Rn on the shoe or a block in both the cases, and direction of Ft is influenced by the rotation of brake drum. If the brake drum rotates in clockwise direction, you can see the direction of tangential force Ft, and if the brake drum rotates in counterclockwise direction, then you can notice the direction of tangential force Ft in second case. So the brake drum rotation direction has an influence on tangential force Ft. Now, if there is a friction, coefficient of friction is there between the brake drum and the shoe. I mean, there is a contact surface between the brake drum and the shoe. So where the friction exists, so that is why the tangential force Ft you can write in the form of reaction force Rn multiplied by coefficient of friction F, so which we will use and can find the reaction force Rn. Now, given data, torque T equal to 500 Newton meter, so that we are writing in Newton mm because the dimensions are given in mm for both the cases, and brake drum is rotating with 1000 RPM, that is capital N, and coefficient of friction small f is equal to 0.25, and brake drum diameter is 500 mm, eccentricity E or C is 50 mm, this is shown in figure, and value of distance B equal to 250 mm and A equal to 750 mm in both the cases. First step is to find a tangential force Ft. So you already know the relation between this torque T and tangential force Ft and brake drum radius. So torque is already given in the question, that is 500 into 10 raised to 3 Newton mm, and brake drum radius is 250 mm. So substituting, we got tangential force Ft equal to 2000 Newton. Second step is to find a normal force on a shoe, that is Rn. So already explained you. So what is the relation between Ft, Rn and coefficient of friction F. So using that relation, so you got Rn as 8000 Newton. So next is to find applied force F. So in that again, first case, that is a clockwise rotation of
brake drum we are considering. So for clockwise rotation of drum, tangential force Ft acting towards the fulcrum point. So this case in data and book, so for that particular figure, so you can find the equation, that is 6.86, page number 88. So we are directly copying that expression, that is 6.86, to find the applied force F value. So substituting all the values in this expression, so you got F value as 1900 newton. The second case, that is a counterclockwise rotation of brake drum. So for this case, tangential force Ft acting away from fulcrum point, so that is when it is a counterclockwise rotation of brake drum. So for that, in particularly in data and book, we are using equation 6.87, again page number 88. So that is our given figure now. Substituting again all the given values, you got F as 2100 newton. So make a note of it. So we are choosing the equations for F depending on the tangential force Ft, either it is acting away from fulcrum point or towards the fulcrum point. So based on these conditions, referring in data and book, you are choosing a particular equation of F. Now the next case, that is a self-locking case. So considering a force F for clockwise rotation of brake drum. So what is self-locking? When there is no force F is applied, either F is 0 or it is less than 0. So you are making expression of F for clockwise rotation of brake drum, writing that and equating, that is less than 0. Again, go on solving. So we have got expression as 1 by F less than or equal to E by B. So finally, you can write it as E greater than or equal to B by coefficient of friction F. So B value is 250 and F is 0.25. So you got E greater than or equal to 1000 mm. So this is the condition. Either it is E or C. So one and same. So if E is greater than or equal to 1000 mm, then it is self-locking for clockwise rotation. And last part is heat generated. Now, unit of heat generated. So you can express this in terms of watt. And again, watt you can express in joule per second. And again, joule in newton meter. So overall heat you can express in terms of newton meter per second. And newton meter per second you can express in force into velocity. So that is how we are writing heat generated in terms of force into velocity. So here force is Ft, that is tangential force, and V is the velocity. Ft we already calculated, that is 2000 newton, and V we can find by expression, that is pi d n by 16 to 1000, where d is brake drum diameter and n is rotation speed of that brake drum, which is also given. So V equal to pi D, that is 500 mm into N, that is 1000 rpm, divided by 60,000. So V you got 26.17 meter per second. So substituting this V value and Ft value, you got heat generated as 52.34 kilowatts.